Welcome students in online class for subject physics. We study the 15th chapter structure of atoms and nuclei. In previous slide we can see a numerical or problem for first orbit when radius and velocity a value is given. Then we can find out angular velocity, time period, frequency, current, many things can be find out using the formulas. Means you have read video number 2 in last Wednesday. I give some formulas, relations, linear and angular, and using that formula today we have seen the two formulae for centripetal acceleration and centripetal force. Here if we know the two terms, velocity of particle velocity of electron V equal to E square upon 2 epsilon 0 h n and radius of circular orbit epsilon 0 h square n square upon pi m E square. Today we want to find centripetal acceleration. We know that in chapter 1 rotational dynamics, there is a definition. That definition is acceleration which is directed toward the center of circle along the radius. Such acceleration is called as radial acceleration or centripetal acceleration, and its value will be v square upon r, or sometimes it is also having r omega square. Why r omega square? Because we know relation v equal to r omega. If we can substitute the value of v, r square omega square upon r, r get cancelled. So your answer will be r omega square. Any formula can be used. If we substitute the v, if we substitute the r, what happens here? V is E square upon 2 epsilon 0 h n bracket square upon epsilon 0 h square n square upon pi m E square. By rearranging the term, you can write as E raised to 4 upon 2 square, that is 4. Epsilon 0 square, h square, n square multiplied by pi m e square upon epsilon 0, h square, n square. If we see carefully, no term will be cancelled, but their powers in multiplication they are adding. So here numerator will be pi m e raised to 6 upon, in denominator its value will be 4 epsilon 0 square 1 epsilon, that is epsilon 0 cube. So here h square, that is h raised to 4, n square means if we can rearrange the term centripetal acceleration, then your formula will be pi m e raised to 6 upon 4 epsilon 0 q h raised to 4 bracket close into 1 upon n4. Here n square that becomes n raised to 4. It becomes n raised to 4. If bracket term is constant, so we can say that centripetal acceleration is inversely proportional to fourth power of principal quantum number. Means today we have seen centripetal acceleration, and that centripetal acceleration is inversely proportional to fourth power of principal quantum number. Using that formula, we also determine centripetal force. Similarly, we say a definition, a force, centripetal force. Its definition will be a force which is directed towards the center of circle. Such force is called as centripetal force. There are two types of force: centripetal force, centrifugal force. Centripetal force is directed towards the force, and centrifugal force is directed away from the center of circle. Directed towards the center of circle and away from center of circle. The force which is away from center of circle is called as centrifugal force, and the force which is directed towards the center of circle is called as centripetal force. Here, centripetal force is equal to mass multiplied by centripetal acceleration. We know that Newton's second law of motion, force is equal to mass into acceleration. So here, centripetal force is also equal to mass into centripetal acceleration. So we know that mass m multiplied by centripetal acceleration is v square upon r. So we can say that centripetal force is equal to mv square upon r. We can use the term that force in first Bohr's postulate. That first Bohr's postulate is, for circular motion, a force is necessary. That force is called as centripetal force, having value mv square upon r. If we can substitute the value of v and the value of r here, what happens? M into value of v will be e square upon 2 epsilon 0 h n bracket square upon r. R is epsilon 0 h square n square upon pi m e square. What happens here? If this squaring the bracket, the value will be centripetal force is equal to m multiplied by e raised to 4 divided by 4 epsilon 0 square h square n square multiplied by whatever pi m e square upon epsilon 0 h square n square. So what happened here? Any term not cancel, but mass and mass, it becomes m raised to 2, means pi m raised to 2 e raised to 6 upon 4, this epsilon 0 square, this epsilon, that is epsilon 0 cube, h square, that is h raised to 4 into n raised to 4. If we can rewrite centripetal force. Then here we can say that in bracket pi m square e raised to 6 upon 4 epsilon 0 q h raised to 4 bracket close into 1 upon n raised to 4. Means if bracket term is constant, so centripetal force is inversely proportional to fourth power of principal quantum number. Means acceleration and centripetal force is fourth power of principal quantum number. So here, in first postulate, another force, that is electrostatic force, is there. If we can find out electrostatic force, so what happened? Electrostatic force that is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 e square upon r square. If we can substitute the value of r, what happens? See here, 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 multiplied by e square upon epsilon 0 h square n square upon pi m t square bracket square. So what happened? The term can be written as 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 multiplied by e square upon epsilon 0 square h raised to 4 n raised to 4 upon pi square m raised to square e raised to 4 bracket close. If we can rearrange the term, that is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 multiplied by e square multiplied by pi square m square e raised to 4 upon epsilon 0 square h raised to 4 n raised to 4. What happened? Pi get cancelled. Another term will not cancel. So we can write it as pi m square e raised to 6 upon 4 epsilon 0 q h raised to 4 into 1 upon n raised to 4. If bracket term is constant, then electrostatic force is also inversely proportional to fourth power of principal quantum number. Means in first postulate we see that for circular motion centripetal force is necessary, and this centripetal force provides electrostatic force. Means electrostatic force and centripetal force both are same, having same values, but here formulas will be different using their laws. According to Coulomb's law, formula for electrostatic force will be 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 e square upon r square. And whereas, according to definition of centripetal force is equal to mass into centripetal acceleration, and therefore, centripetal force equal to mv square upon r. But their values will be same. See here, both formulas, if we can see their formulas, bracket will be same. Means centripetal force, electrostatic force are inversely proportional to fourth power of principal quantum number. In next, tomorrow, we will see energy, kinetic energy of electron, potential energy of electron and total energy of electron. Both will be seen in tomorrow. If these terms are understand, then we can prepare a chart in tomorrow.